गुड ईवनिंग वैए सपोर्ट करुपर कूटम अंड वैए अपोज मिस्टर रंगराज पांडे द रीसेंट कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी सराउंडिंग दि करुपर कूटम यूट्यूब चैनल अंड देयर लेटेस्ट वीडियो ऑफ आभास पुराणम वेर दे हैव नॉट ओनली सेट डिरोगेटरी अंड चीप रिमार्क्स ऑन लॉर्ड मुर्गा बट दे हैव गॉन ऑन टू टेल अ थर्ड रेटेड ट्रांसलेशन टू वन ऑफ द सेक्रेड टेक्स्ट ऑफ हिंदूस कॉल्ड द कंदर्षष्ठी कवसम Though we know under whose patronage this Karupar Kootam YouTube channel works, I do not want to get inside the details of it. Karupar Kootam has deliberately outraged the religious feelings of millions of Hindus, also known as the Sanatana Dharmis, across the world. While many hues and cries are seen in the social media from Hindus, and equal and opposite reaction has been given by the Hindu outfits, there has been a very sluggish approach from our government and political parties. There are a lot of commotions in the minds of common people and they are having no clue as to how to react to this controversy. Now, I have neither come here as a representative to take a stand in favor of the Hindus, nor I have come here as a representative of the jurist person of Lord Murugha as his next friend, which I am technically and legally allowed in the court of law, like in the matter of Ram Lalla in the Ram Janmabhoomi case. The Honorable Supreme Court of India has held in several judgments that a jurist person has the right to litigate any case while being represented by its manager, trustees or its next friends. I am here to tell you only 3 points and then I will rest the case to you to decide and act. What are the legal remedies available for the affected Hindus? Why I support Karupar Kootam and why I oppose Mr. Rangaraj Pandey? Point number one. What are the legal remedies available to the affected Hindus? Article 19 of the Indian Constitution gives all the citizens the right to freedom of speech and expression, but subject to the reasonable restrictions for preserving inter alia public order, decency and morality. At the same time, freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion is enshrined in Article 25 of our Indian Constitution, which has given me an immunity to practice my own religion. Therefore, Karupar Kootam, they have the freedom of speech and I have the right to practice my religion. Both are equal and I don't have any problems. But the problem here is when Karupar Kootam cross the boundary and start hitting below the belt, which amounts to hate speech, hurting religious feelings and intentional insult to Hindus, etc. I have, to the best of my abilities, tried to collate and present 10 sections under the IPC, Indian Penal Code, under which people or organizations like Karupar Kootam can be challenged legally. I will try to explain the sections in short and also try to give you an idea of the offense and punishments as given in the Bar Act. Number 1. Section 153, Section 153 of IPC. Wantonly giving provocation with an intent to cause riot. Here, this Karupar Kootam has intentionally, they have used this video to provocate with an intention to cause riot. Whoever, the act says, whoever malignantly or wantonly by doing anything which is illegal gives provocation to any person intending or knowing it to be likely that such provocation will cause the offense of writing to be committed, shall, if the offense of writing be committed in consequence of such provocations, be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 1 year or with fine or with both, and if the offense of writing be not committed with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 6 months or with fine or with both. So now let us see the next section under which we can take legal action. Section 153A. promoting enmity between different groups on ground of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, etc., and doing acts prejudicial to maintenance of harmony. Now let us see what is the punishment that can be given for promoting enmity between classes. It is 3 years or fine or both. And if they are promoting enmity between classes in place of worship, etc., the same punishment shall be for 5 years plus fine. Now let us see the next section, which is section 295 of IPC. Injuring or defiling place of worship with intent to insult the religion of any class. So here let us see that destroying, damaging or defiling a place of worship or sacred object with intent to insult the religion of any class of person. Here we consider the holy text of Kandasashti Kavasam book itself as a sacred object. So here under section 295, a person can be punished for 2 years or a fine or both. The next section, which is a very important section, called section 295A of IPC. Deliberate and malicious acts intended to outrage religious feelings of any class by insulting its religion or religious beliefs. So let me try to explain this section. Whoever with deliberate and malicious intention of outraging the religious feelings of any class of citizens of India by words either spoken or written or by signs or by visible representations or otherwise insults or attempts to insult the religion or the religious beliefs of that class shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 3 years or with fine or with both. So here this section is very very important pertaining to this case. Now moving on to the next section, which is section 298 of IPC. Uttering words etc. with deliberate intent to wound religious feelings. Here uttering any word or making any sound in the hearing or making any gesture or placing any object in the sight of any person with intention to wound his religious feeling will attract 1 year of imprisonment or fine or both. Now moving on to one of the common sections, which is generally known to most of the people. It is section 499 and section 500. Section 499 of IPC deals with defamation. Whoever by words either spoken or intended to be read or by signs or by visible representations make or publishes any imputation concerning any person intending to harm or knowing or having reason to believe that such imputation will harm the reputation of such person is said, except in the cases hereinafter expected, to defame that person. So it amounts to defamation. Since we consider Lord Muruga as eternal, so any person who considers himself as a next friend to Muruga can go ahead and file a defamation. And not only that, it is also possible to file a defamation case against a person for allegedly defaming a person who is dead or who is no more. Here, the author of the sacred text of Kandasashti Kavasam, Sri Baladeva Rayar, has composed this beautiful text, but the video which the Karupar Kootam has portrayed it in a very bad shape. We have a classic case in All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam versus Sri K. Govindan Kuttan case in the Honorable Andhra Pradesh High Court on 29th January 1996, where the ADMK through its then General Secretary had filed this suit against Sri K. Govindan Kuttan and Sri T. N. Seshan for permanent injunction restraining the defendants and all persons claiming under them from releasing, publishing and causing sale of the book entitled Seshan, an Intimate Story, with the passage containing reference to late Sri C. N. Annadurai and late Sri M. G. Ramachandran, both the former chief ministers of Tamil Nadu, by connecting them with the CIA either directly or indirectly. Section 500 of IPC talks about the punishment for defamation. Whoever defames another person shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now, let us move to the next section, which is Section 504 of IPC. Here, whoever intentionally insults and thereby gives provocation to any person intending or knowing it to be likely that such provocation will cause him to break the public peace or to commit any other offence. Here, the classification clearly mentions that it has to be an intentional insult. Insult must be such as to give provocation to the person insulted. I do not want to explain both the points, as both are very much evident in this particular matter. The punishment here is imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now, moving on to the next section, which is Section 505 of IPC. Statements conducting public mischief. So here, the statements creating or promoting enmity, hatred, or ill will between classes. Whoever makes, publishes, or circulates any statement or report containing rumor or alarming news with intent to create or promote, which is likely to create or promote on grounds of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, caste, or community, or any other ground whatsoever, feeling of enmity, hatred, or ill will between religious, racial, language, or regional groups, or castes, or community. Here, the punishment, which is imprisonment, which may extend to 3 years, or with fine, or with both. The last section which we will be covering in this particular video will be Section 509, which is word, gesture, or act intended to insult the modesty of a woman. While you might have seen the video, they have used such derogatory words while describing certain portions of the translation of the sacred text. They have not only insulted the author, the Lord, but they have also gone on to insult and outrage the modesty of a woman devotee. Here, outraging the modesty of a woman attracts imprisonment for a term which may extend to 3 years, and also with fine. So now we have briefly seen about the sections of Indian Penal Code IPC under which we can take legal action against these Karpar Kutam organization. So now, what is that you can do as an individual? You can file a complaint online sitting at the convenience of your house. I shall give the link to the Tamil Nadu Police online complaint website in the description box. Number 2, kindly consider the situation in your area with regard to corona, and if it is normal or under control, you can go to the nearest police station and lodge a complaint against this organization. In both the cases, you shall be receiving an acknowledgement from the department, which will come to your rescue at a later stage. Number 3, you can create awareness about the available laws to your family, friends, or colleagues. Number 4, which is very important, finally, you can now know or understand the powers vested by our Indian Constitution to each and every citizen for the safety and well-being of the individual as well as for the society. Now, let us discuss about point number 2. Why I support Karpar Kutam? The answer is very, very simple. For everything and everyone, there is a saturation point, and it is tend to break free at one stage. These people are going beyond the saturation point and tolerance level of all the Hindus. They have failed to understand one thing. These groups like Karpar Kutam are in a way creating unity among Hindus, and the more they do such things, the stronger the Hindu vote bank would emerge. Traditionally, Hindus have been very lenient with respect to the atheist groups, but the things are changing now. Every Hindu has started realizing the tactics used by these fringe elements. They are doing this to consolidate the minority vote bank. Now, this marks the beginning of the end to these anti-social elements. So, I sincerely thank Karupar Kootam and other such organizations which are in a way indirectly supporting and they are being a reason for invigorating the Hindu feeling among the common people in Tamil Nadu. They are self-inflicting the damages, and more they do such things, the faster the Hindu vote bank would emerge. Point number 3, and a very important point, why I oppose Mr. Rangaraj Pandey's views. My friend had forwarded Mr. Pandey's YouTube video, which was premiered on Chanakya channel on 14th July 2020, titled Kandasashti Kavasam, Pandey Parvai. And I watched the video where he states, Ivargalai Purakkanippade Sariyana Badiladi, which means avoiding them or boycotting them is the best reply or reaction. I beg to differ from Mr. Pandey in this view. We have been silent throughout. We watched so many things unfold in front of us, and we were not able to do anything because we did not condemn them in the beginning. Napoleon the Great said, "The world suffers a lot, not because of the violence of bad people, but because of the silence of the good people." We have tried to boycott these people and their notorious acts for the past 70 years, but this has given them a license and a free hand to talk more against Hindus and Hinduism. So, let us learn the basics of legal education and the legal rights each and every one of us have got, and the remedies available. Let us start educating others and also react against such hate speeches. Let us become more aware and vigilant. So, with these points, I rest my case, and this is all I have got to tell my brothers and sisters who are watching this video. Let us make the change happen. Thank you. Jai Hind.